get to the video. You guys probably saw me do a video recently on how to load an ATV into my trailer. Well, today we're going to show you how I load my UTV into my trailer. Now, let's get to the video. Now, with my ATV, I used these ramps right here. And let me kind of turn because that wind's blowing. I don't want to be messing up my mic. But I use these ramps right here. They're only 1,000-pound rated. I think my UTV's 1,400 pounds. Let's say even if it was 1,100 pounds, this is not strong enough to hold it. It could possibly give way, crush it, and then I won't be able to use it for my ATV no longer. So I need to use the ramps that come with the trailer that I've heard they're 10,000-pound rated. We've actually put a truck or two in this trailer before, a big old diesel truck, and yeah, they did the job no problem. Now, if you do buy a trailer and it has like a back gate on it, make sure you ask the manufacturer, what's the weight ability of that back gate? How much weight can it hold? Can it hold your UTV going up the trailer? Just make sure you ask. It's not a bad question to ask when you're buying a trailer. And people are usually just asking, how much weight can my trailer hold? Well, this trailer can hold, it's a 2 5,000-pound axles, but the trailer can only hold about 7,000 pounds because you have to take in consideration what the trailer weighs also, which is almost 3,000 pounds. But people just ask usually, how much does my trailer hold? Well, 7,000 pounds. Okay, I'm gonna buy it. Well, just because the trailer can hold 7,000 pounds, can that back gate hold 7,000 pounds? Something to ask always, guys. Make sure you ask. Anyhow, moving on. I'm gonna go ahead and set you guys up. I'm gonna get this off because we don't need that. It won't work. And I'm gonna get the right ramps set up and let's get her loaded. And then we'll go from there how I strap her down. Now these just have a little hook right here that just hooks into this groove on this trailer. But yeah, so now that you guys have seen me, you can see my chicken legs again, and I'm wearing the same clothes, which I'm actually wearing Josh Gammon's awesome t-shirt. Go check out his channel. But yes, I did two videos in the same day. This is just continuation of me showing you how to load my ATV, which if you all watched that video, you remember when I did the whole skid out to turn my ATV onto there. So this is the same day, guys. I'm actually taking my UTV in tomorrow to get it, the valves done. I'm having the dealership do it. And then I'm also gonna figure out what the heck that squeak noise is on my engine mounts that squeaks really bad. And it's under warranty still, so no worries there. But, oh, why am I going reverse? Let's get her loaded up. Now, you know, this obviously you can't turn sideways. You got to drive straight up, you know. Always make sure you go far enough forward also when you're pulling up, you know. You don't want to just stop right here and have all your weight over your tires. You want to make sure you have weight up front that's pushing down on your truck. Okay, I actually kind of went sideways because I'm filming and not paying attention to what I'm doing. So let me get over to where I should be here. But I always go up about like that. So that what that's doing is putting some tongue weight on your truck. If I have to explain that, how to haul a trailer, you guys might not want to be learning how to load up a UTV yet. You might want to take some classes on how to haul a trailer. So I'm not going to go down that explanation very much. But that's where I put her. And shut her off. And let's get her strapped down. Now the biggest thing that I do that's probably different than a lot of people when I tie this down is I use two straps in the front, one going from here to there, from here, which actually the Honda says to strap it from this bar right here, this area right here. It actually almost tells you you can do any of this bar right here. So I put my strap from here and I go to this anchor point on my trailer. I use two straps in the back. Now then I come over here and I put one strap from that anchor point. I go through this D-ring on the hitch on it, go through it and come over to there. And that's one ratchet strap. The front two straps are just pull tight straps. And then I come over here on the side because I have these anchors down here, right here. And I put a strap from here to here. Now, a lot of people ask me, why do I do the side straps? Well, if you're going and you turn really sharp with this thing is very, very, very top heavy. I don't think it would flip off or flip on its side, but if I have the extra straps, why not use them and not find that out? So I'm going to go ahead and get her strapped down and then show you guys the aftermath. It's kind of getting dark, so I'll try to hurry up here. All right, everybody. Well, it's not dark yet. It's pretty darn close, though. But we got her strapped in there. So just like I said, I went through that D-ring, went to there, went to here. Got those side ones on right there, which help keep the quad tight to there. That's pretty tight. Have the front straps, like I said, on it where I said I'd put them. And I didn't tie this one off though. Kind of in a hurry. I'll check it over a little bit better when I'm done with the video, because I'll still take it out on the road tomorrow to take it in, like I said, for the service. Sorry about that, guys. I had some people walking by. I don't want them to have to be in the video. So, anyways, moving on. So, the back's still tied down. Now, everybody always asks me, how do I do this on here? I'm not nothing fancy on it. I will just tell people, you tie it off how you want to tie it off. I'm not going to get in that whole spoo about it all. Anybody has any ideas, maybe show or tell in the comments. But I just tie it off. Now, I know how to roll it into the ball and do the whole trucker thing, But you guys do what you think's right on it. But same thing on this side, just tied down and tied down to the front. Kind of step back a little bit so you can see it. So it's got the two in the front, one on each side, and then the Y in the back. So kind of see down there again. So that's how I tie it down, guys. That's how I put my UTV to step off to the side of the truck and kind of give you an idea how much it's really sitting in the front to put that weight on the front axle for the truck. So that's where I put her at, and it works great. All right, guys, I just want to say thanks for watching. As always, keep the powder dry, and this is how I load my UTV into my trailer. We'll see you on the next one. Hopefully the next one will be a winch being installed. I have the parts, just need to get her back from the shop and get her done. All right, bye guys, I talk too much. Bye.